Okay, so this is the generated signal from directly from the PIC microcontroller, 12F508 is there. This is the I made some wiring linking there and to test it actually on my breadboard when I had everything on the breadboard. Right now I don't have it anymore there, but I leave that red LED as indicator that is working, and all those wiring there are basically making that happen, that indicator LED work. And also to hook up the my oscilloscope here, and also those three wires, red, black, and white, also for the breadboard. But now I don't have it anymore. I build this remote control with the components from the breadboard, so that's why I don't have the breadboard circuit anymore. But what I did, I took it out from this. This is my PIC-E2 programmer for the PICs, and I took this board out from here and move it there on the table and test it on the breadboard with those three wires. That's basically what I did, and I used this circuit, that being the infrared, but linked to GP0 on pin 7, not like this here, but it's practically the same circuit what we have. So okay, this is the frequency that is generated automatically, but repeatedly actually. Come on, focus today, like that. I can cycle a little bit. So it's still not that. 1 millisecond, 2 milliseconds, 5 milliseconds, 10, 20, 50 milliseconds, 100, 1 second, and so on. And going back. Yes, this, and now down, it's the actual signal. Yeah, 10 microseconds is the minimum. And yeah, okay, so this is the, you know, cycling through all the timing that is having there. My dinky oscilloscope, as you can see, it's not a clean oscilloscope. Come on, focus, if you can, like that. We have there some, see those tiny blimps, that shouldn't happen. It's from this oscilloscope, because it's the cheap one, the cheapest, but it's doing its work. I mean, yeah, it's doing its job. Okay, now the code, hopefully you can see anything like that. This is the entire program, as you can see. Wait a second, like this, you see, it's empty. Under, I made it high like this to see that is actually, this is the entire program. I will make it lower right now, and that's what is important, that part that is generating the entire frequency. There is some math behind it. I cannot say uh I remember everything. This 10 and 16 is a frequency or something that it must be like 33 kilohertz or something. I don't remember exactly right now. I'm not sure. I was doing it not parallel, in the same time with Mr. Steve, and he made some calculations. He was keeping an eye on some things, and I was doing the actual programming, what to do and where to change and what to change, basically. He is more knowledgeable than me, but that's the frequency we had to keep it constant, kind of, to be all the time, this 16 and 10 delays. And this comments that I put here are actual how to explain to you, one execution of the program is a bit complex thing we did here, but we made it after all. We figure it out in the end. We got a signal of if we executed only this part without the loop, for loop, so only this part alone was taking on oscilloscope 50 microseconds, and we were wondering why is 50? It was too much, because we should have 26 microseconds. And we figured it out that this execution. So one program execution, one line of execution. This is one line of execution of the program is taking some time as well, some microseconds to execute in the itself. This part I figured it out. This is my part that I figured it out. So Mr. Steve, he is the electronic guy, but I am the programming guy, also the artist as well. And so one line will take three microseconds. I put this microseconds here from my ass. I don't know exactly how many, but I kind of smartly figured it. Guessed. It's a smart guess what I did. It's close enough to the reality. And in total, if you add all this for this behind the scenes, there is ensembler. This is in high C programming, the C level, which is high level of programming. But behind the C level is converting back to ensembler, and from ensembler actually is converting to hexa, binary. But the hexa code is executed as well, and I think there are like three lines for detecting to set a single pin as on or off in assembler. That's why I put three there. And here for this delay, I think it's five. Around 5 or something, plus 16, which is the delay itself time, 16 microseconds. So 3 microseconds plus 5 microseconds plus 16 microseconds plus another 3 microseconds plus 5 that is taking for the delay execution, the move worker, you know, move file to worker, move worker to something in assembler language, and then plus another 10 microseconds that is the delay itself. So in total is close to 50, not exactly 50, because I put from my ass these numbers here, but I smartly guess what they could be, how much they could be, like that. Because I know a little bit of ensemble, I'm not that good, but I know a little bit, and I know how it's working. And figuring this thing out, we figured out that initially we wanted to be exactly 26 or 30, the frequency or the beats per microsecond, basically. So 16 beats up and 10 microseconds not working, and 16 working, like that, high and low. 16 is high and 10 is low. And let me draw it a little bit for you. Let's see. I'm making use of screenshot here. So 16 is high, and then 10 microseconds is low, and then again, this is one cycle, and then it's getting high again for 16 seconds, and then getting low for another 10, and another block like that, and all these things will be like 30 times, actually 30, and let me get out of that, and after that another delay, after all this looping, another delay that is doing that, but that is this is the code explained like this, but in reality it was a little bit more more problematic, because let me search if I can find it very quickly here. Set configuration, no. the first one probably here. No, I don't know where I put. I think back here. No, advance, no, shit. See how to search. I think. No, shit. This one. This is the one. So, what it took. Actually, I will film it like this. This is my experience that I had with this program, what I did step by step, and I will slowly going down, and you should pause it and read all about it if you are interested, of course. And this is how we figure it out, and like this. So yes, that's the entire process. It's by elimination. I will not stay and read all of this. You should pause it if you want and read the process that we managed to how we figure it out to work. So back here, I used extensively this little oscilloscope linked to the peak itself there for a couple of days, but I tried to program it for a couple of weeks, the peak itself, to remember everything, to read a lot of stuff. I didn't read too much, actually, but I read before when I was learning it, and now I kind of remember everything that I learned. And this is the remote control that is already having a new peak in it, brand new. And let's see from my chair here. Voila. It's working like a charm. Actually, I should do it like this. Like, let's see. Cool, huh? Is the angle. It's very directional. Okay, my time is up here. It's very directional, the lead and the receiver. They should be exactly on the same line, perpendicular and everything. Yes, this is it. Thank you for watching, and hopefully, I don't know, you like it. Bye-bye.